when you bat your best, there's no distractions. You're engrossed in the game. You're in, I guess, the zone, a little bit cliche. You're not really consciously thinking about anything. You almost let all of that practice, all of that hard work sort of take over. I'm doing it with an element of freedom, and I'm not worried too much about the risk or getting things wrong. Actually, I'm taking the game on, and you know, I think that's probably where my game's made a huge shift over the last couple of years. I'm Sophie Luff, captain of Western Storm, and I'm a top order batter. My first memories of cricket would have been probably 5 or 6 years old in the garden. My dad played club cricket, still does play club cricket, believe it or not, and I've got a younger brother, Jack, who was always in the garden throwing balls at me. I was always throwing balls at him. So it started from there, really. I remember every weekend, every Saturday was spent at our local cricket club, and yeah, I just fell in love with the game from there, really. Yeah, I'd say both my experiences at school and at club were, I was a sole girl in a lot of boys' teams, and to be honest, that was the norm for me. I actually really enjoyed it. I was a bit of a tomboy growing up anyway. I loved playing football, playing cricket, and I found myself in those environments more often than not. I thought it was a real challenge. I always sort of had a point to prove, I guess, being the only girl. You used to get a few comments around, oh, they've got a girl playing, and I always wanted to show my worth, and I think that's something that stayed with me throughout my career, really. Yeah, I think as captain, there's a responsibility on me to lead from the front. I make no bones about it. I talk openly about wanting to lead from the front and put in as many match-winning performances for Western Storm as possible. I'm incredibly passionate about the club, about the team, and I want to see it go from strength to strength. And, you know, with me as captain of the ship, I guess, it's on me to sort of lead the way, pave the way for the next girls coming through. And, you know, one thing I'd like to think that I will do is sort of leave it in a better place than what it was when I started my captaincy stint. You know, having a really positive impact on what cricket is played at Western Storm, how we go about things, both on and off the pitch. Yeah, I absolutely do see myself as a role model to younger girls in the dressing room, as a senior player in the environment. I work on the academy as well as a coach, so I can see the next crop of players coming through and feel like I can have a real positive influence on some of those girls as well in their development and hopefully their careers in the future. But I also want to inspire the little girl that comes along to a Western Storm game and experiences cricket for the first time sat in the stands. And I think we've all got a role to play in that, but it's something that I really enjoy doing and take a lot of pride in.
Hi, I'm Neve Hollands. I'm 17 and I'm an all-rounder for Western Storm. I always enjoyed it from the start, and it was something my parents always said. You want to do something you enjoy when you're older, and I think it's something that's kind of stuck with me. Ultimately, I'm playing with my mates. It's something that I have to be grateful for. I probably forget about that quite a lot when I get kind of hooked up in things. Probably say when I got to about 14, I got asked to play for Somerset Women, and at that level, I kind of thought, oh, I'm really enjoying this, and kind of my competitive side kind of came out a lot more. And I was like, I looked up to a lot of people in the Western Storm side that are in it now. For example, like Sophie Luff. I saw that I played with her with Somerset, and she also played for Western Storm at the time. And I thought, oh, I could do this. And obviously it's all happened very quickly for me, which is exciting. And someone like Luffy and Fran, they're kind of, what they saw ahead of them was, I have to play for England to be a professional cricketer. But for me, that stepping stone is I can play for Western Storm and do it as a job, do it as a living. Whereas probably at my age, they probably thought, what other job could I do alongside playing cricket? So I think it's made it a lot easier for people my age, and they can definitely see a pathway to where they want to go.
Hi, I'm Fran Wilson. I play for the Western Storm. I'm a batter and I'm vice captain. How do I feel being seen as a successful woman in sport? First of all, a bit of imposter syndrome. I just kind of play cricket. But then I guess if you think about it a little bit, you do feel like a bit of a pioneer, especially like the era that me and my kind of age group grew up in. I don't think we'll see that again, where you're literally the only girl in a boys team and kind of all those hurdles that you had to overcome, but you didn't even think about it at the time. So I guess a bit of a pioneer and a bit of history that, you know, you've taken the game to the next level. Yeah, that would be how I feel about it. So the way that the women's game has developed in the last 5 years, there's so many girls playing and it's across all different demographics now. I think before it was girls with brothers would be playing, but now it's girls who used to play hockey who'd come into the game, state school, private school, everyone. So I think it's a lot more accessible. So Lights A Chance To Shine's probably really helped. And also along with that, I think the level of the girls coming in. So the ones who are like 17, 18 now have had really good support since they were probably 11, 12, like really good coaching. And I think that's meant that they're ready to play the professional game, the international game, a little bit younger. Yeah, it's quite scary how good the kids coming through now are. So basically, I feel like a whole new professional level of the game has been added, but the facilities and the infrastructure is still behind, still where it was. And it's amazing that we've now got however many pros across the country, but if you've got all these pros and they've got nowhere to train, it's kind of a bit conflicting. So I think there needs to be a real push and a real emphasis on facilities, coaches, physios, and it's pretty urgent. So that would be the barrier for us right now as professionals.
Hey, I'm Nat Rafe. I'm a wicketkeeper batter for Western Storm. Like, the mental side of the game, I'd say I've struggled with more than the physical side, especially after becoming pro and like feeling that pressure of like, this is my job, I want to keep my job. It's definitely quite hard to deal with that sometimes. I think the progression in women's sport has been like quite evident recently. So you've had the Women's Euros. I've definitely been following that and I've seen some quite big crowds there. And just like speaking with my friends about it, which you maybe wouldn't have seen in the last few years. And I think you can see the same in cricket, like the World Cup in Australia was very well viewed. Oh yes, I've seen a huge change in the last 5 years in women's cricket. So like now I'm obviously, you have the opportunity to make it your career. And whereas before it would probably only be the England girls that have that chance, it's now people playing at a regional level that gets to do that as well, which is really good.
The one piece of advice I'd probably give to my younger self and give to younger girls coming into the game now is just remember why you play, like know why you play, because like I said, there's so many highs, so many lows, but you can always come back to why you play. So for me, it's because I love the game and I love playing with my teammates and like I'm hungry to succeed. I've always got that drive, that ambition. And I think if you can keep coming back to those reasons, then you'll keep waking up the next day and going to the gym and putting in that hard session, turning up, doing your skills, doing everything that's required of you as a professional cricketer to, you know, keep getting better day on day. So yeah, remember why you play.